As we are in the festive mood of celebrating Mother's Day, it is important to know that each one of us carry anima animus, male-female principles within. Apparently on the surface, you may be male or female, but deep within, in the psychology, there is two principles, anima, animus, male, female, or Shiva and Shakti. Unless these unite together, you will not attain to total harmony and oneness within. The very purpose of the inner life is to understand the hidden principle of your being. If you are a male, the hidden feminine aspect. If you are a female, then you have to be aware of your hidden male element. And these two always remain in conflict with one another. And because of that, we find always that we are not able to make the quick decisions when any circumstance and situation comes. In real situation, you will be able to see who is intelligent only if you have discovered your anima or animus, the hidden principle within. Once you have discovered that hidden principle, you are balancing your innerness. Then your intelligence will move at its optimum level. And then any situation comes in, the real situation, when any circumstance and situation comes, you will interact, not react. That's why I use the word, you will respond to that situation with your total intelligence. And intelligence is the outcome of inner harmony between anima and animus. So on this day, when the world at large celebrates the Mother's Day, you have to know the inner principle of anima, animus, male, female, yin and yang, Shiva and Shakti, and the harmony between the two leads to intelligence. We go on polishing the mind in schools, colleges and universities with the hope that we will be able to create an intelligent humanity, but this is a fallacy. We try in many ways. Our stupidity is such that for 5,000 years we have been doing this, and yet we have not realized the fact that humanity has not become intelligent at all. Man can become intelligent only if he knows the hidden principles, the yin and yang and their art of balancing them, the yin and yang, the two aspects of the brain, the left and the right side. In case of a male, one side is, in case of a man, one side is feminine and the other side is masculine. And vice versa is the case in case of a woman. On the contrary, human beings have become more and more unintelligent. And they have lost the capacity to use their intelligence when an actual situation comes. When real life situation comes, they have failed to use their intelligence. And when they are not able to use their intelligence in the right way, stress is the outcome, and I will feel very proud saying that I am stressed out. Indeed, stress is improper use of your intelligence. Firstly, you have to discover your intelligence, and then you have to know the art of using the intelligence in the right way. In fact, the uneducated persons seem to be sharper and more intelligent than the so-called professors, the scholars and the pundits. Of course, the professor knows many words, he can quote scriptures, an uneducated person knows no information. But put them into the real situation and you will know who is intelligent and who is not. In fact, the real situation brings the litmus test for the intelligence of the person. And in a real situation, you will find that the uneducated one behaves more intelligently than the educated one. The educated one, the pandit, the priest, the professors, they feel that by obtaining the university degrees or the status, they are intelligent. It is said of Edison that he had two cats, and sometimes he had to wait for the cats to come in at night. Somebody suggested, why don't you make a hole in the door so you can go to sleep, and whenever the cats want to come, they can come in and they can go to sleep. There is no need to wait for them. Edison liked the idea. The man who had suggested it was his own servant, absolutely uneducated. Two holes ascended. Edison, the man who invented 1,000 scientific gadgets, the gramophone, the radio, the electric bulb, and so on and so forth. In fact, without Edison, you would have been in difficulty living, because all gadgets are his inventions. And the servant was utterly uneducated. The next day when the servant came, he was puzzled. He asked Edison, what have you done? Why have you made two holes? He said, but I have got two cats. And how can two cats pass through one hole? The servant could not believe him. What nonsense was Edison talking? Indeed, it is always in the real situation that you will be able to see who is really intelligent. The challenge has to be new, otherwise the scholar will win the race. If it is sometimes old that he knows about, then he will seem to be very intelligent. But if it is something absolutely new, about which he has no information, he will prove less intelligent than the uninformed, uneducated person. The uninformed person has to depend on his own consciousness, and the informed person depends on his memory. That's the difference. Intelligence evolves out of your consciousness. Consciousness is subtotal of all the moments that you have lived in awareness. When you live moment to moment in awareness, in total alertness, then a moment comes that something explodes and becomes your platform from where you operate. And that platform is your consciousness. As compared to that, a man of words, a man of information, acts out of memory. That is where the difference lies. The uninformed person has not much of a mind, but he has some natural quality of meditativeness. Consciousness is the outcome of meditativeness. And meditativeness is the root of intelligence. The more meditative, the more conscious you are, the more intelligent you are. Intelligence is the phenomenon of meditativeness. Each child is born with intelligence, this meditativeness. It is our natural ingredients, natural inheritance. It is not something that has to be learned. Meditation has only to be discovered within. It is hidden behind the layers of the mind. And the whole process of meditation is to cut through all these layers so that you can rediscover your natural intelligence, your inherent inborn quality. And to be naturally intelligent is to be blissful. And to be naturally intelligent is to know what life is all about. Life is not a problem to be solved. Instead, life is a mystery to be lived and rejoiced each moment. In the beginning, naturally intelligent one is bound to experience godliness all around. But mind is mediocre. The man of words relies on the mind. Mind is memory. Indeed, all minds are mediocre. The great minds and the small minds and the medium minds too are all mediocre. They differ only in the degree of their mediocrity. But intelligence means glimpse of no mind, glimpse of meditativeness, explosion of inner harmony, explosion of oneness. And all the original instincts have arisen out of that state of no mind. Meditation, intelligence, consciousness, moment-to-moment awareness, inner harmony, bliss, all this emerge out of the state of no mind. When you have transcended beyond the mind and its duality, I call that state meditation. Meditation is the art of slipping out of the grip of the mind, just as a snake leaves the old skin and enters into the new. Coming out of the old skin is coming out of the mind. Meditation is the art of slipping out of the grip of the mind so that you can see existence as it is, without any prejudices. Then there is a great light, clarity and understanding. And to live out of that clarity, understanding, and out of that light is to live a life of celebration, a life of benediction, a life of harmony, a life